morning. Here's what's going on at Risen Savior this week. In your worship folder today, you'll find plastic bags available for you to fill up for Grace Lutheran's food pantry. That food can be dropped off in this basket anytime during the month of December.
It's almost time to start decorating the church for Christmas, and it's a great opportunity for families, connect groups, anyone to get involved. Contact the church office for more information.
Be sure and check the Angel Tree and the Gammon Elementary Tree in the Fellowship Hall for ways to serve others this holiday season.
It's basketball season. That means it's time to play basketball in our multi-purpose room. It's open for men ages 21 and up, so see the church office or your bulletin for more information.
Don't forget, on Thanksgiving Eve, we will have a worship service at 7 p.m. Once again, the children will be bringing fruits and vegetables to the front of the altar area that night.
Due to the Thanksgiving holiday this week, the Folders team will meet on Wednesday morning at 9:30. Also, due to the Thanksgiving holiday, the church office will be closed Thursday and Friday.
If you're interested in volunteering or providing food for the Valley Center Thanksgiving, make sure and see this display in the Fellowship Hall today. The deadline to order poinsettias is today. Be sure and stop by the information table in the Fellowship Hall for more information. Articles for the December news and activities page are due today. Make sure and have all your required information into the church office.
And remember, this isn't all that's going on at Risen Savior. Be sure to check your announcement pages and follow us on social media. Thanks for being here today. Have a great week.
Drive homes, living. Good morning. Boy, that asked a lot of questions, didn't it? But you know, we're the last Sunday of the church year. It's really what it's for. It's a time for us to evaluate, to reflect, but not to get into a negative zone, but instead, look how awesome God is and what He's got in store for us. So as He unpacks that to us today, let's rise as we worship Him. We begin our service as we do all things, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, ever one God, world without end. From His Word. Show us Your unfailing love, O Lord, and grant us Your salvation. I will listen to what God the Lord will say. He promises peace to His people, His saints, but let them not return to folly. Surely His salvation is near those who fear Him, that His glory may dwell in our land. Love and faithfulness meet together. Righteousness and peace kiss each other. If my people would but listen to me, if Israel would follow my ways, how quickly would I subdue their enemies and turn my hand against their foes? Those who hate the Lord would cringe before Him, and their punishment would last forever. Come and listen, all you who fear God. Let me tell you what He's done for me. I cried out to Him with my mouth. His praise was on my tongue. If I had cherished sin in my heart, the Lord would not have listened. But God has surely listened and heard my voice in prayer. Praise be to God, who has not rejected my prayer or withheld His love from me.
Life is filled with sorrow, and there are days when the pain just lasts and lasts. But I know there'll come a day when all our tears are washed away. Every heart said,
Lord be with you. Let's pray. Loving Lord Jesus, just as the disciples and those around you struggle to believe, so do we. We live faced with doubt, questions, and struggles. Just as Pilate, we ask, what is truth? Give us your Holy Spirit. Fill us with your Spirit as we turn to your Holy Word. Empower us to listen and to believe. Fill us with faith as we seek to live in your grace. We praise you, our coming King, who came once in humility and who will come again in glory, and who rules for all eternity with the Father and the Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. This morning we have the opportunity to receive some new members, and I'm going to ask them to please come forward at this time. Notice the excitement as they come forward. Nancy's going to come on up too. We are glad that you are a part of our fellowship. And to put you all on the spot, I told you I was going to be asking you a couple questions, right? But I'm not just going to ask you. I'm going to ask all of you. Okay? Are you ready for this? Anybody here desire to be a member of Risen Savior Lutheran Church? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
You're not alone. That's great. Does anybody here agree with the teachings as you've come to know them to be true according to the Word of God? If so, answer, I do. Anybody here want to help what the Lord has given this congregation to do with a portion of your time, talents, and treasures? If so, answer, I will. Man, the future looks great, doesn't it? Some new people that have joined our midst. Nancy, would you please introduce them?
I just want to tell people that there is an insert in your bulletin that kind of talks about our new members. And I'll start over here, okay, you guys? And Trent and Krista are recent KU grads, right, and relocated. What's that?
I was actually Emporia.
Oh, Emporia. Oh, okay, and KU. And relocated recently in Kichai. And so we want to welcome them. They've got two dogs, and we're so excited that that you're here. And I heard, Trent, you've gotten out and played basketball some with the new basketball group. So welcome. Very glad you're here. All right. And this beautiful family here, they've just recently moved from New Mexico. And so we're really glad that they're here, too. And Cruz and Ashley, and they're four beautiful girls. And Cruz, can I ask you to introduce your girls?
This is Avery, newborn baby of the family. Okay, Vanessa, Alyssa, and Alana.
Okay, so Avery, Vanessa, Alyssa, and Alana. So we're so glad that you guys have joined us, and we welcome you, and it's great to see you. Thanks.
And as you look at all the name tags, you'll know who's who. Thank you guys for coming out. Encouragement, what God has called us to do with one another. Encouragement from God, but as we look to the future, to really be filled with that excitement and anticipation about what all is going to be happening next. Well, that's what Isaiah is going to do for us. From Isaiah chapter 51.
Listen to me, my people. Hear me, my nation. The law will go out from me. My justice will become a light to the nations. My righteousness draws near speedily. My salvation is on the way, and my arm will bring justice to the nations. The islands will look to me and wait in hope for my arm. Lift up your eyes to the heavens. Look at the earth beneath. The heavens will vanish like smoke. The earth will wear out like a garment, and its inhabitants die like flies. But my salvation will last forever. My righteousness will never fail.
Isaiah began that with such a simple statement. Voice of God saying to us, listen to me. You know, we've got so many things calling on us, who want us to listen and pay attention to them. So as God speaks to our hearts today, there's a challenge from John in Revelation. What or who Are we really listening to Revelation 1?
To the seven churches in the province of Asia, grace and peace to you from him who is and who was and who is to come, and from the seven spirits before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead and the ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood and has made us to be a kingdom and priests to serve his God and Father. To him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. Look, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him, and all the peoples of the earth will mourn because of him. So shall it be. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty.
God gives his answer to any of the questions we might possibly have. Amen. Well, doesn't mean we don't have questions. It just means we know what the answer is supposed to be if we're willing to listen to it. Pilate, in our gospel lesson for today, is loaded with questions. Please rise as he shows us what we need to do with our questions. John chapter 18.
Pilate then went back inside the palace, summoned Jesus, and asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" "Is that your own idea?" Jesus asked. "Or did others talk to you about me?" "Am I a Jew?" Pilate replied. "It was your people and your chief priests who handed you over to me. What is it you have done?" Jesus said, "My kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my servants would fight to prevent my arrest by the Jews. But now my kingdom is from another place." "You are a king then," said Pilate. Jesus answered, "You are right in saying I am a king. In fact, for this reason I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone on the side of truth listens to me."
So I guess that's the question, isn't it? Who are we really listening to? Let's talk to God about it. Almighty God, as I stand before your holy throne, I confess my unworthiness to be in your presence. I realize I don't live as a kingdom person. Forgive me when I do not listen to you and try to stay on middle ground like Pilate. Forgive the arrogance of my spirit, the fear of my heart. Lord, I give you my brokenness. Give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my sighing. Listen to my cry for help. My King and my God, for to you I pray.
If it's not one thing, it's another. Caught up in
a sinner, if it's not one thing, it's another. Caught up in words, tangled in lies. But you are a savior, and you take brokenness aside and make it beautiful, beautiful. I am a sinner, if it's not one thing, it's another. Caught up in words, tangled in lies. You are a savior, and you take brokenness aside and make it beautiful, beautiful.
Pilate was in that situation where, rock and hard place, no win situation. Ever been there? But he knew what to do. He called Jesus to him. He said, I need to know the truth. You ready for that truth? Through faith alone in Jesus Christ, all our sins are forgiven. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Please be seated.
You are holy. You are mighty.
You are worthy.
You are worthy.
Worthy.
And you know, that really pretty well says it all, doesn't it? When we understand who he is, what he is, what he's done, where he's going, what's that do to all your worries, your fears, your frustrations, your anxieties? Man, we can list so many different things that we go through in life and the emotions that we have. And it all boils back down to one thing. Who or what are we really listening to? This world comes at us with so many different tools to try and get our attention. So let me ask the question again. Or no, it's not a question, it's a statement. It's a statement from God. God says, maybe, possibly, no, it's real. We need to differentiate two words. The difference between hear and listen. Does that surprise you that there's a difference between those two? This is one of those times of the year, since it's the last Sunday, that we really need to spend some time and evaluate. And I struggled with kind of coming up with some words here to do this. I don't know if it's the word motivation, inspiration, dedication, all those shun words that are out there. That really, what is it that inspires you? What is it that gets your clock going, that really just gets your pump going in such a way that you're really excited about stuff? Well, I found this picture. Is that what it is? Some external source, something that you need your caffeine in the morning to get going, or when the alarm clock went off this morning, how many of you went, yeah, let's go? No, didn't happen, huh? Well, to be honest, it didn't happen for me either, so that's life, right? It shouldn't be that way. What if we really tuned in to God, listened to the Alpha, the Omega, understand that God's got this world and he's in charge of all this stuff, and all we really need to do is just listen. Maybe it's because we listen like this. God says don't, and we do. God says stop, and we go. You saw the opening video, right? All those options that are out there that are laid before us in life, and how we respond when these challenges and these things happen called life. Do we live our lives in fear? What happens when I say ISIS? Or do we live our lives filled with an excitement for what's next? Did some searching on the internet to find this picture, this image, because I know a picture is worth millions of words. And I want you to have this image of fear. Real fear. Terror. It's my disclaimer before I show you the next slide. So are you ready for this? This might give you nightmares. Okay? This is the image of sheer terror. What happened? Anybody scared? Well, poor kitty. Did you hear what you did when I put up this image of terror? You laughed. What would happen if we did that in life? When we hear this news from the doctor, we hear this stuff happening on the news and on TV, our Lord says, be of good cheer. I've overcome the world. What would it be like if we lived that way, if we really listened to him? Well, the movie's coming out, so here we go. Lucy says, "So what do you think?" Charlie Brown says, "What difference does it make? You never listen to me anyway." Been there? "So what do you think?" "I was just making conversation." When you make conversation, you have to listen too. Been around Lucy lately? Been Lucy lately? As we have those conversations with God, as we try and understand what's going on in our lives and in the world that we live, that we really take the time to listen to Him and receive that peace which surpasses all understanding. You know, I found this one and it spoke volumes to me. This idea of sometimes we're not hearing impaired, we're listening impaired. To that our Lord speaks to us. He says, "I am the Alpha, the Omega. I am the one who is, who was, who is to come." Any questions? Any concerns? Any worries? You hear the power that that begins to bring into our lives with a symbol for infinity. That no matter what the world, the devil, or our own sinful flesh throws at us, God's going to work it to His glory and to His praise. And for us to be an opportunist to grab a hold of that and let it be part of our joy every day instead of our worries every day. Those of you who know my wife know that she has a way of making me do things I normally don't do. A couple months ago, we were down in New Orleans getting ready for the national youth gathering down there, and she wanted to see some stuff that we'd take the Kansas district to. So we went to a cemetery. Ever been in a cemetery in New Orleans? We went to what's called number 2. It's the second oldest cemetery in New Orleans. And we're walking around and just, you know, taking in this historic, wow. And God, in His sense of humor, I don't know why, saw this tombstone. The guy's 35 years old when he died. He was a firefighter. 149 years ago that he died. Now you're trying to read that, aren't you? Does that help? All together say, no. How's that? Why do we mourn for dying friends or shake at death's alarms? This but the voice that Jesus sends to call them to His arms. Why should we tremble to convey their bodies to the tomb? There once the flesh of Jesus lay and left a long perfume. Wow. It's written by that famous author, Anonymous. Wow. Even in death, the victory. Even through His suffering and innocence, victory. In Christ. What does that mean? Well, the world looks at it one way, and God shows it to us, and He says, it's important that you read and listen not to what the world says, but what I say. Remember, conflicts happen because they don't all see things the same. So I'm going to ask you what you see on the screen right now. Some of you see a saxophone player, right? How many of you see the face of the woman? Who's right? They're both, because they're both there. But the reality is, one group is going to say, no, that's what... So the voice of truth The voice of God who speaks to our hearts and says, even though you may be going through trials or difficulties, even though it may be everything's so fantastic, the challenge is, who are you listening to? And the way that that really kicks in is to know the purpose of why we are here. Did you hear that in our gospel lesson for today? Pilate says, who are you? Why are you here? What are you doing? Who are you? Did he want the truth or not? Albert Einstein put it this way: what is right is not always popular, and what is popular is not always right. And so Jesus said, I came to testify to the truth. You know the rest of that story too, don't you? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Where are you at on that journey right now? Still living in fear? I pray that's the type of fear you have this week. That when it comes your way, it gives you a good feeling inside, because you know the rest of the story. In Jesus' name, amen. Please rise. God's peace, which really does surpass all understanding, keep your hearts, keep your minds, keep your lives filled with the joy of knowing Him. Amen. Let's join together in professing our faith as we join in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated as we make offering to our Lord.
I can see waters ranging at my feet. I can feel the breath of those surrounding me. I can hear the sound of nations rising up. We will not be overtaken. We will not be overcome. I can walk down this dark and painful road. I can face every fear of the unknown. I can hear all God's children singing out. We will not be overtaken, we will not be overcome. The same power that rose Jesus from the grave, the same power that commands the dead to wake, lives in us, lives in us. The same power that moves mountains when He speaks, the same power that can calm a raging sea. Same power that can calm us. conquered our enemies. No power of darkness, no weapon prevails. We stand here a victory. Greater is he that is living in me. He's conquered our enemies. No power of darkness, no weapon prevails. We stand here in victory. The same power that rose Jesus from the grave, the same power that commands the dead to wake, lives in us. Lives in us. The same power that moves mountains when he speaks. The same power that can calm a raging sea. Lives in us. Lives in us. Lives in us. Lives in us.
That same power lives in each and every one of us. Wow. What's that do to fear? What's that do to worry? As we look at the world we live in and we hear fear, we hear ISIS, we turn to our Lord and ask him to release his power. A lot of our youth, high school kids, are at the district youth gathering at Hutch today. As they return, we pray that they return changed, lifted by him. This last week, we've heard, and you'll see it in your bulletin as you read through the prayers, several that have been diagnosed with some serious health issues. Let's rise as we talk to God about it. Father, today, as we come before you, we recognize your lordship over all things. Help us, Lord, to listen to your word, to listen to you as you come to set us free, to inspire, to motivate, to encourage, to fill us with the joy of our salvation, regardless of what the world, the devil, even our own sinful flesh throws at us. Lord, in your mercy, we look to the people that are especially in harm's way. We look at ISIS and we look at the sense of terror. Remind us again, Lord, who's ultimately in charge. And so as we see all these things in this world that we live, help us see beyond this world and the salvation that is ours through faith alone. Lord, in your mercy, when we hear the stories and the reports from doctors and medical staff, again, Lord, we turn to you. We recognize your power over all things. As we ask for your healing graces, we also know your greatest healing has already happened through your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy, as we look at commitment in those who have joined officially this congregation today, we ask your hand of power of release into the future. Inspire us, motivate us, and let us sing our greatest joys to you. Regardless of what had transpires. You're an awesome God. For the privilege of growing in you, be with our youth as they return. Let it be a gathering of your saints filled with your spirit. Lord, in your mercy. Father, this week, we as a nation have set aside a time to focus on Thanksgiving. Help it be exactly that. A time of thanking you for all the giving that you have done for each and every one of us. Let us have those God sightings that inspire and fill us with you. All this we bring before your throne and we lay it into your hands. That, O Lord, is where we commend all for whom we pray as we trust in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil.
is the kingdom.
You're going to hear a lot of stuff this week. As you hear it, run it through this filter. The Lord bless you, keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor. Celebrate his peace. Amen. And it happens because of what we believe. Again, good morning. Thanksgiving is this week, and you note the schedule for Advent, and everything is in your bulletin. And for those of you who have been celebrating the last couple days with your high school kids being gone, they are coming back this afternoon. In the meantime, let's celebrate being our Lord's as we greet one another to his glory.